Irish Centre for inviting me to read a few poems. My poems that I've chosen are, some of them are about death, which I think is the one thing we can all be sure of in life, and a couple of the others are about love, which is one thing that we all hope for in life. Anyway, first one is called Child Burial by Paula Meehan. Your coffin looked unreal, fancy as a wedding cake. I chose your grave clothes with care, your favourite stripy shirt, your blue cotton trousers. They smelt of wood smoke, of October. Your own smell was there too. I chose a Guernsey of hand-spun wool, warm and fleecy for you. It's so cold down in the dark. No light can reach you and teach you the paths of wild birds, the names of the flowers, the fishes, the creatures. Ignorant you must remain of the sun and its work. Spin time back, take you again within my womb, your amniotic lair, and further spin you back through 9 waxing months to the split seeding moment you chose to be made flesh, word within me. I'd cancel the love feast, the hot night of your making. I would travel alone to a quiet mossy place, and you would spill from me into the earth, drop by bright red drop. This one is called Affinity by George Russell, also known as A.E. You and I have found the secret way. None can bar our love or say us nay. All the world may stare and never know. You and I are twined together so. You and I, for all his vaunted width, know the giant space is but a myth. Over miles and miles of pure deceit, you and I have found our lips can meet. You and I have laughed the leagues apart in the soft delight of heart to heart. If there's a gulf to meet or limit set, you and I have never found it yet. You and I have trod the backward way to the happy heart of yesterday, to the love we felt in ages past. You and I have found it still to last. You and I can mock time's fabled wing, for a kiss is an immortal thing, and the throb wherein those old lips met is a living music in us. Death of an Irish Woman by Michael Hartnett. Ignorant, in the sense she had monotonous food and thought the world was flat, and pagan, in the sense that she knew things that moved at night were neither dogs nor cats, but pukas and dark-faced men. She, nevertheless, had fierce pride, but sentenced in the end to eat thin, diminishing porridge in a stone-cold kitchen. She clenched her brittle hands around a world she could not understand. I loved her from the day she died. She was a summer dance at the crossroads. She was a card game where a nose was broken. She was a song that nobody sings. She was a house ransacked by soldiers. She was a language seldom spoken. She was a child's purse full of useless things. Heirloom by Anne Hartigan. My father said, "It's always good weather." Staying home. You're staying in bed.